This episode of SciShow is supported by Brilliant. To see if you can finish today's daily challenge, go to brilliant.org/scishow. There are tons of cooperative relationships in nature, and one of the most obvious is between bees and flowers. Bees visit flowers for their tasty pollen and nectar, and they help pollinate the plant as they go. We've known about this for years, and it's so basic that you probably learned about it in elementary school. But hold on to your juice boxes and kickballs, because this story is more interesting than we thought. In fact, there's a third, much tinier member of this relationship. Yeast. Yeast is a fungus found all over the globe, and the types that live in your garden do a bunch of important jobs. For instance, they help plant matter decompose, and they help roots absorb nutrients and water. Some of them also hang out in nectar, where they feed on its sugar. So there's obviously some plant yeast friendliness going on here. But as for how pollinators factor into that, that took a bit to sort out. Like, because yeast eats the nectar's sugar, pollinators might get less nutrition from yeasty nectar, so maybe they'd avoid it. Then again, a 2018 study showed that yeast can change a nectar's scent by altering its chemistry, and we know scent affects pollinators too, so maybe that factors into this somehow? Really, there are a lot of variables. So in 2019, a group in Belgium set out to get a better understanding of this role yeast actually plays in the pollinator-plant relationship. In one experiment, they took buff-tailed bumblebees and introduced them to a field of fake flowers. Some contained a yeast and sugar solution, while others just had sugar water. They had hypothesized that the yeast would negatively impact the bees' behavior and health. Except, well, not only did the bees show no aversion to the yeasty flowers, the yeast helped their colonies grow. The hives that ate this nectar even had fewer larvae die, which led to more worker bees and an overall healthier colony. We'll need more research to say why, but the authors think this could be because yeast stores nutrients in its cell walls, so even if the nectar has fewer nutrients, the yeast might ultimately help the bees. Through other tests, the team even discovered that yeasts could suppress the growth of a bumblebee gut parasite called Crithidia bombi, which might play a role in the overall decline of honeybees. Again, the team isn't totally sure why, but they suspect the yeast could be out-competing the parasite for food in the bee's gut, which is pretty metal for a single-celled organism. So based on this, it looks like nectar full of yeast is helpful for bumblebees. And the bees help the yeast too. As they move from flower to flower, they take the fungi with them and spread them around. And just to really come full circle here, that's even good news for the flowers. A study published in 2010 found that yeast gives off heat as it breaks down sugar. So yeast in nectar increased the flower's temperatures by up to 6 degrees Celsius. Then, another study published in 2013 found that bumblebees are more likely to feed from warmer flowers, probably because it makes the nectar less sticky and easier to drink. So, the yeast might be making flowers more appealing to bumblebees too, and since bumblebees are pollinators, well, it's a happy love triangle for everyone. If you love asking questions about the world, you might also have fun with Brilliant's daily challenges. Every day, Brilliant puts out new challenges that test your math and science skills. But the great thing is, they also give you all the context you need to solve the problem, so you don't need formal science training. The challenges cover everything from cryptograms to daring river rescues, and if you want to learn more, you can go to brilliant.org/scishow. Also, if you're one of the first 200 people to sign up for a premium membership at that link, you'll get 20% off an annual subscription.